Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you AMQP protocol in great details. Let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll explain you basics of AMQP. Then I'll explain you AMQP architecture. After that, I'll explain you frame structure of AMQP protocol. At last, I'll explain advantages of AMQP protocol. Let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of AMQP protocol. See, AMQP means what? It is advanced message queuing protocol. So it is not just message queuing protocol, it is advanced message queuing protocol. Usually this message queuing protocol, which is advanced one, which we use it in banking system. So for banking transactions, we use this, like as if you have banking transaction with UPI. If you have NEFT transfer, so for that, whatever messages are getting forwarded for transaction, that can be done with the use of this protocol. So usually you'll be observing this AMQP protocol that has been used in banking sector, right? See, it is open standard application layer protocol. This is open standard protocol, and that is application layer protocol for message oriented middleware. So here message oriented middleware is there. Right, so AMQP, that is functioning as a message oriented middleware, right? And as I have told you, this is advanced protocol for message queuing, and that is used in banking transaction in majority of cases, right? See, AMQP is mainly used in transaction messages between servers and users. So here, whenever users are using banking application, so in that situation, usually we use this protocol, as well as this protocol can be used in IoT system even, right? I'll show you varieties of ways by which AMQP can be used in architecture. Right now, you should know this. See, AMQP is mainly used in transaction messages. Mostly it is used in banking servers and banking applications, right? See, it uses TCP for reliable communication. TCP is connection oriented protocol, right? Which is functioning at transport layer. So TCP is used over here for transportation of messages. So at transport layer, TCP is there for this protocol, right? See, endpoints acknowledge acceptance of each messages. So here reliable communication is happening. So for every forwarding of message, there will be acknowledgement for acceptance of message, right? See, it follows public subscriber model for communication. In architecture, I'll show you how it follows public subscriber model for communication. Now, let me explain you architecture of AMQP. See, it follows public subscribe model. In public subscribe model, I have explained there is a producer or publisher, right? So publisher is publishing topic. In public subscribe model, I have explained publisher is publishing topic. Subscribers are subscribing topic, and based on subscription, they will be receiving messages. That is how public subscribe model is there, right? Producer or publisher, they are publishing topic, and that goes to broker, and broker will be forwarding topic wise messages to subscriber. That is how it functions, right? But here, this is advanced message queuing protocol. So there are a few more functionalities. See, with broker, here we have exchange. Exchange will define how routing will happen. So here there are four types of exchanges which is there with AMQP architecture. See, one is direct, second is topic wise, third is fan out, and fourth is header. Let me explain you all different categories of exchanges. See, producer will be forwarding message or a topic, right? So that message which is getting forwarded over here, that will be having key, or you can say binding key. So whatever message that comes over here, that is having binding key. Now based on key, broker will define to which exchange that message should be forwarded. So based on binding key, it will forward message to category of exchange. Let us consider here message comes from producer that is having binding key, which is related to direct exchange. So as if message is there with direct exchange, exchange will observe that binding key, and based on that, it will forward message to the queue. Queue means there will be buffer in which messages will be there in queue. and one by one it will be given to consumer, right? So based on binding key, message will be given to queue. There can be so many queue. Here I have shown you one queue only, right? So based on binding key, direct exchange will forward message to the queue. Now see here, producer can produce messages. It could be based on topics even. As if messages are there based on topic, then two different topic, exchange will forward that message. So exchange will see to which topic that message should be given. Once it is there with particular topic, it will be forwarding message to the queue over here. Now you will be thinking like, what is the meaning of this? See here, consumer can subscribe to different topics. Let us say here we are having five different topics: temperature, humidity, sensors. Likewise, there are five topics. So here producer will be giving message along with topic name. Here exchange is topic, right? So exchange will see which topic is related with this given message. Based on that, it will be given to topic. After that, that topic message will be given to different queues, right? And whatever consumers are there, they can access that message from the queue, right? So based on topic, here message forwarding is happening, where exchange is topic type. See, third is fan out. So here whenever producer is producing message, as if it is having message related fan out, then fan out will be forwarding messages to multiple queues. That is well defined. You can say here routing is defined, right? Here routing is defined, that even one can say. So here routing that is happening based on fan out, where multiple topics are receiving, multiple queues are receiving same message, right? So that is how exchange is forwarding with respect to fan out. See, sometimes message may come with exchange of header. If it is happening as per header, then in header there is well defined routing which will be given. Based on that only it will be forwarded to queue and routing will be done, and at last consumer can receive the message, right? So here architecture is public subscribe based architecture, but in that there is advanced version. Previously we were just observing like publisher is publishing messages on topic, and from topic that was going to the subscriber. Here see, broker is having four different types of exchange, right? So this is bit advanced version. Previously broker was having only topics. Right now exchange is having different categories, right? And based on that messages are forwarded to queue, right? And at last consumer can receive the message. So that is how basic architecture is there, right? Now let me explain you frame structure of AMQP protocol. If you observe frame structure of AMQP protocol, in that you see frame header is there. This is fixed frame header. With frame header we are having size DOFF. This is also related size of frame, then type of frame, and to which channel we are forwarding it. Here another segment is there, that is extended header. That extended header is depending on type of frame. And then payload means frame body is there, where content will be there, right? So here if you observe frame header, so that is having size of 8 bytes. It is mandatory. It contains information needed to parse the rest of frame itself. For example, total frame size and frame type. So this frame header is fixed. It is having size of 8 bytes. It defines what is the type of frame as well as how frame is getting structured, right? See, next is extended header. This extended header is having variable size that depends on frame type. And third is frame body. See, in frame body, sequence of bytes has format that depends on frame type. So in frame body or in payload, sequence of bytes will be there, and those bytes are there based on frame type. See here, if you talk about frame types, then there are varieties of frame types that is available with AMQP protocol, like open close. So to open the connection and to terminate the connection, open close is there. Begin and end. So to begin with the connection and to end with the connection, these two frames are there. Attach and detach. Attach and detach will establish a link in between two nodes, right? And detach will terminate the link in between two nodes. Transfer is there for transferring of data. Flow is there regarding flow control that will define at which rate data should be forwarded, and then deposition frame is there where many other parameters of frame can be defined, like what could be the data rate, what should be the frame size, how data should be forwarded, many other things that we can attach over here. So that is how different frames are there with AMQP protocol, and structure is like this. Right. Now let us discuss about AMQP advantages. See, it supports many messaging schemes. I have shown you in architecture, it supports many messaging schemes, right? There are four types of exchanges, right, in this protocol. So it supports different types of messaging schemes, and that is also useful in IoT, right? So it supports three level quality of service. See, there are three level of quality of service. One service that belongs to message without confirmation. Second is there with message with confirmation, and third is there with message with double confirmation. So that is how it supports three level quality of services, right? It can be extended easily as it is open source, and there are many other features that will be probably getting added with this protocol in future even, right? So it supports many open source libraries by which one can enhance this protocol even, right? It supports many library, so you can optimize your application along with this protocol even. See, inbuilt security is there with this protocol, right? TLS inbuilt security is there. Along with that also, there are so many other features that is provided which give security to this protocol even, right? So that is how advantages are there with this protocol. I hope you have understood this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.